This is our finished product, pizza and breadsticks.
Hello, today we're gonna make some pizza dough, that we're gonna let rise overnight in the refrigerator.
Our ingredients are 2 tablespoons of Italian seasoning, 2 tablespoons of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of salt, 6 cups of all-purpose flour that I'm gonna sift. And then for our yeast, we've got one package of yeast, a tablespoon of sugar, and then we'll get 2 cups of warm water to proof the yeast in.
And some more bread, and some more flour. We're gonna mix that. Have to sift it.
Okay, now I've got my 2 cups of warm tap water, and I put some sugar in there, about a tablespoon of sugar. Now I'm gonna put my yeast in there. Kind of mix it around a little bit. Get all that in there. Oh, that's sticking. And just kind of get that where it's moist. And let that set about 5 minutes. We'll start making our dough. Okay, now I put my flour mixture into my mixing bowl. And I've got my yeast and water mixture, which it's bubbling. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's proofed up, you know, it's bloomed. So I'm gonna put that in there. And we'll put our dough hook on here. This dough hook will need it for us. But after a couple of minutes, first couple of minutes, I want to check it, make sure it's going to be right consistent, make sure it's not too wet or too dry. So we're going to go. And you always want to start out on slow when you got dry ingredients or they'll go everywhere. And I got my little boy here. Sometimes he likes to turn the switch up on me, so I got to be careful.
Let the machine.
That's really smelling good with that garlic and Italian seasoning. Man, it smells really good. Okay, now I started mixing it, and after a couple of minutes, it was still pretty dry. Still had some crumb in there. When your dough is good, it'll all pull away from your bowl. The hook will make it pull away, and it wasn't doing that. So it needs a little more liquid, and I decided to put about a tablespoon of oil in there, and it's pretty good consistency there. You always want to stay by your stand mixer, or it'll that's pretty heavy, and it'll make it walk off the counter, so you need to stay with it. Okay, I think we've got it mixed and kneaded, and looks pretty good. It's dried up where we can handle it. Next, we're gonna put about some oil. I've got a plastic bowl that I got a good tight fitting lid on it. So we'll put, make sure there's enough oil in there. You know, a tablespoon, maybe a little more. To coat our ball of dough. And we'll get that out.
I'm gonna buy the bread.
And make it into a ball.
I'm gonna wash your hands.
And we'll rub, make sure you get all rubbed around good. Coat it good. The bowl's coated good. Because this is going to rise, and you want it oiled up so it doesn't stick to the bowl. So now, let's put a lid on it and put it in the refrigerator and let it rise, do its first rise overnight, an overnight rise. If you weren't doing an overnight rise, you'd probably have to do it in a warm, moist area for probably about an hour, but we're going to do this overnight so we can do it, get up tomorrow and make our pizza. Now our dough is ready. It's set overnight in the refrigerator, and it's at a slow rise, so I'm going to punch it down, and I'm going to try to get two pizza crust and some breadsticks out of this dough, and really smelling delicious. Okay, we got our dough out here, and I'm just gonna try to cut it off in about three sections. I'm gonna take one of these, and I've got my pizza pan already sprayed with cooking spray. I'm gonna try to form me a dough out here. This is really dense, so I've got out my rolling pin. I'm gonna roll it out for my crust. We'll check back on this after I get it rolled out. Okay, I've got it rolled out, and I've got it in my pan, and I'm gonna let it sit and get a second rise, probably about 15 or 20 minutes. And then I'm gonna prick the dough with a fork and pre-bake it for about 5 minutes or so before I start adding my toppings. Now, the last part, third part of our dough, I'm gonna roll out with breadsticks. I'm gonna melt my hand, put them on a pan. I'm gonna put these, I pricked them with my fork, and I'm gonna put them in the oven and bake them till they're pretty close to being done before we add our toppings. That way we'll have a good crispy crust. Okay, there's our breadsticks done, and they look delicious.